if you want to add, if you want to remove the class, you can use link dot class list dot remove. Let's say that you want to remove that link class, it's going to be like this. So save this, and now you can see that we only have one class, the one that we added in the previous lines. So that's going to be also important. So for example, let's review how you can work with IDs. So we can add something like link.id equals to new ID. And now you can see we have an ID right here. And this is going to apply to any element. We only have this link, but this same technique is going to apply to any HTML5 element or any HTML element. You can add, for example, remove the ID. Of course, an element will contain only one ID. So you are going to add link ID equals to nothing and save. And now you can see that the ID is empty. You can also add remove the ID by adding link. And we can use something called remove attribute. And we pass the ID. This is going to remove everything. So now that we have this attribute, let's use the attribute functions. There are several functions, attribute functions. And for example, I'm gonna continue sending values to the console. We're gonna add element equals to link, a dot, and we're gonna use get attribute. And we're gonna pass the attribute that we want to retrieve, which in this case is going to be the href. So save this, and you can see we have the pound sign. You can also use this syntax to return the class in this case. Class like this is going to return the class, but I recommend that you use class name or class list. The same way as we have get, we have also set functions. So for example, if you want to change the href, you can use element equals link set attribute. And then you need to pass only the attribute href and then the value. http://facebook.com in this case, for example, save this, and now you can see we have href and it says Facebook. If you want to add a new attribute that doesn't exist, you can add something like element equals link set attribute, and you can add, for example, the target. We can add underscore blank. Save this, and now you can see we have target underscore blank. In HTML5, for example, you can create custom attributes. So you can add something like link set attribute and add something like data link and then pass, for example, number 10. And this is going to create a custom attribute, data link and the value 10. If you want to check if an element has an attribute, you can use link has attribute and you pass the name of the attribute. Data link in this case. So save this and you can see we have true. If you want to remove an attribute, you can use the same as we saw in the previous example, remove attribute. So element equals link remove attribute. And we pass the attribute, data link. And you can see that this removed the attribute. So basically in JavaScript, you have full control of all the nodes and everything into your DOM. You can change everything, you can update something, you can add new values, update the values, or remove any attribute using all these functions that we saw in this video. So in the next video, let's see what are event listeners and how you can create your first event listener in JavaScript.